Well, Jean, the crimes seem to be happening late night or early morning at places that stay open later than most. Police say these places are supposed to serve students, but a few bad apples may be ruining it for everyone else.
Often open until 4 a.m., the Wild Catessen at UNH is a big hit with students.
Because of that, we have an awful lot of individuals in here, and unfortunately some of those individuals don't have the best of intents.
Quiet during the day, but at night, 50 to 100 students have been known to pack in here.
Hearing from students, it was almost a rite of passage to be able to just walk in there, grab a sandwich, and walk out the door.
Deputy Police Chief Paul Dean says an officer watched the cameras one night and made 7 arrests in 2 hours. Police started keeping watch, and managers have made some changes.
They're going to place an order pay at that time, and then they'll receive their product once it's prepared. In the past, we allow them the flexibility to kind of pay as they were leaving, and many times that item would leave in the jacket.
They will also be closing an hour earlier.
That's doable?
Reasonable. Yeah, I can handle that.
Students say it's an on-campus treat that they don't want to lose. And as for some of their classmates stealing,
I feel like if they want to do that, they're ruining it for, like, other people.
At the library, it's not sandwiches they're walking off with.
You want to believe that it's just a prank. And maybe one or two issues during the fall could be considered that. But, you know, it seemed to be happening every single night, every single day.
More than a dozen restroom soap dispensers have been pulled from walls and several light bulbs stolen. There is also vandalism. And police say homeless people are hiding in the building and staying after it closes. Officers say with all of this and the store thefts, they've had enough.
Every time they steal there, they're stealing from themselves because it's their student money, their tuition, their fees that pay to have these things open for them.
Now, the deputy police chief says that since they increased their presence at both places, made changes, and even reached out to the student senate, it seems that the crime has slowed down. Reporting live, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.